Come to me with you. Here. And I will walk through this door, and I won't be overcome. I won't be overcome. And for the Lord is, and He is able, and He is faithful. And I will walk in your promise. I walk in your victory. And I will walk in your power. And I won't be overcome. No, I won't be overcome. For the Lord is, He is able. And He is faithful. You're higher than the mountains that I face. Every season I will press on. For God alone is on the throne. For the Lord is, He is able. And He is faithful.
Faithful, higher than the mountains that I face.
where the word at the beginning, one with God the Lord Most High, hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you our Christ. What a beautiful name it is, what a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ my King. What a beautiful name it is, and nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without us, so Jesus, you brought heaven down. But my sin was great, your love was greater. What can separate us now? And what a wonderful name it is, and what a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ my King. And what a wonderful name it is, and nothing compares to this. And what a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. Oh, oh yeah. 'Cause death hold you, the veil tore before you, you silenced the boast of sin and grave. Well, the heavens are roaring the praise of your glory, for you are raised to life again, and you have no right. You have no equal, now and forever our God reigns. For yours is the kingdom, and yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names. And what a powerful name it is, and what a powerful name it is, the name glory, yours is the name above all. sin and grave. Will the heavens all roaring the praise of your glory? For you are raised to life again, and you have no rival, and you have no equal. Now and forever our God reigns. For yours is the glory, yours is the kingdom, 'cause yours is the can stand against. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus.
Post of sin and the grave with that. Amen. Pastor Shirley, could you grab a microphone and receive the offering for the evening? Praise the Lord. This way I can get myself together, see? You're not comic relief. You're on purpose. Amen.
Glory to God. All right. There. God. Father, in Jesus' name, we just thank you right now for the privilege of coming into your house to give you praise and worship and to honor you. We thank you, Father. You said that where you are lifted up, that you will draw all men unto you. I thank you so much, Father, that we have the privilege to sow into your kingdom, to bring our tithes and offerings to you, that it is seed well sown into your kingdom, that it'll produce a bountiful harvest of souls, and that those souls will come to share the gospel with other people throughout the world. I give you praise, honor, and glory for multiplying this seed into our lives so that we can be a blessing to others as we come across them. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Richard. John, didn't I just see you behind the board? It's like, man, you're all over the place. This is good. Well, welcome our live stream family. Welcome NCM people. Hallelujah. Pastors Bob and Diane are here. Let's give them a big God bless you. Woo-hoo! If you're looking for a church and you're up in New Glasgow, we know where there's one. It's a good one. They're great people. Praise the Lord. So say this with me. We believe. No, really. We believe. Miracle days are here again. The glory of the Lord is on this service. We declare the manifest presence of God is here. We declare the manifest power of God is here. And we declare the manifest goodness of God is here. In Jesus' name. I want to talk about, I got a title for you. Don't be discouraged, be faithful where you are. Amen. Don't be discouraged, be faithful where you are. And let's start off in Proverbs chapter 28, verse 20. Woo! A little weak. Yeah. Come on, Proverbs 28, 20. Yeah. There you go. Come on, Fran, I couldn't even hear you. There you go. Welcome. And it's the first part. A faithful man or woman shall abound with blessings. The New Living Translation says, the trustworthy person will get a rich reward. The Message Bible says, committed and persistent work pays off. Living Bible says, the man who wants to do right will get a rich reward. There is a reward for faithfulness. And I looked up faithful in the Hebrew, and it's E-M-U-W-N-A-H, emunah, emunah, ooh. But it means, is that where amen comes from? Come on now. Amen. Be it unto you as unto me, right? It means literally firm, secure, set in office, stable. Faithful people are stable. They're steady, trustworthy, steadfast. Look around this room. It's Thursday night. It's full of faithful people. you're steady to come in here. Dictionary.com says, a strict or thorough in the performance of a duty, like a faithful worker, true to one's word. Come on. Promises, vows, etc. Steady in allegiance or affection, loyal, constant, faithful friends. We all have faith. Well, we should have some faithful friends. Amen. Reliable, trusted, and believed in. So if we go to we go to the law of first reference, dealing with the word faithful, it's in Exodus chapter 17. We can go there, please. Exodus 17. We've taught on this. Pastors taught on this. There's been a lot of teaching on this, and it's good. So I want to take it at Exodus 17, verse 9, please. You ready? Are you there? Okay.
Hold on.
Are you here now? How about now? Okay. Verse 9, and Moses said unto Joshua, choose us out men to go out and fight with Amalek. Tomorrow I will stand on top of the hill with a rod of God in my hand. So Joshua did as Moses said to him and fought with Amalek. And Moses and Aaron and Hur went to the top of the hill. And it came to pass when Moses held his hand up that Israel prevailed. When he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. That's, come on, that's the same as the word. You hold the word up, you will prevail. You set this word down, not so much. Verse 11, and it came to pass when Moses held his hand up that Israel prevailed, and when he let his hand down, Amalek prevailed. But Moses' hands were heavy, and they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat thereon, and Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands. Stayed. And pastors taught on this, it's grasp, lay a hold of, or seize. They grabbed his hands. They saw that there was a need, and they just jumped in and grabbed it. They saw his hands starting to fail. They said, oh, no, not on our watch. That will preach. So Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands, one on one side and one on the other, and his hands were steady until going down of the sun. That word steady is the same word as faithful. It is the same word if you look it up in the Hebrew. And I went, wow, that's kind of neat. So it was steady. Keep your hands up. Right? Stay faithful. They were faithful to do that. And as a result of that, it says, and Joshua, verse 13, Joshua discomfited. That is a good word. That means beat the living stuffing out of them. There was nothing left. He discomfited Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. And we have a sword in our mouths, don't we? And look at this, verse 14. And the Lord said unto Moses, write this for a memorial in the book and rehearse it in the ears of Joshua. We need to be rehearsing our victories in each other's ears. Do you remember when we won that? Do you remember when we moved into this building? Do you remember when we moved from Scarf Court? Do you remember when we moved from Keddies? Come on. And they tore it down because we were done. Really? We were done with that building. It's always like, hey, we're good. So, rehearse it in the ears of Joshua. Rehearse in the ears of your Joshuas, people that are working around you. Rehearse the victories, right? Because as you rehearse the victories, faithfulness gets implanted, right? Amen? So, and then, you know, you get so full of faithfulness that discouragement cannot stay. It just flushes it out. So in Nehemiah chapter 7, verses 1 and 2, it says, and King James, now it came to pass when the wall was built, I had set up doors, and the porters and the singers and the Levites were appointed. Verse 2 is where I want to get to. That gave my brother Hananiah, the ruler of the palace, charge over Jerusalem, for he was a faithful man who feared God more than most. He was faithful and he feared God more than most. You could put he was faithful, period, take a breath, and he feared God more than most. That's two things here. And in the New Living, it says he was a faithful man who feared God more than most, faithful God and feared God above many. Feared God above many. That is some serious stuff. And we, you know, we've heard the word fear, respect, reverence, in awe of. And he did that more than anybody else. So if you're so full of that and everywhere you go, you're just reverencing God, what's going to happen? Miracle days are here again. The glory of the Lord is on the service. The glory of the Lord is on you. Come on. The glory of the Lord is on this church. Why? This is what we do. We fear God here. We don't play with God. He's not our drinking buddy. No. We come in, it's like what Pastor said, come in low. You come in low. Let's go to Psalms 112, please. Psalms 112. It's such a good one. They're all good. It's like Pastor said, today, this is a good one. Tomorrow, I'll have a better one. And the day after that, it'll be even gooder. Psalms 112, verse 1. It says, praise ye the Lord. Blessed is the man or woman that fears the Lord. Fears the Lord. And delights greatly in his command. Do you delight greatly in his word? Do you like it?
Yes.
Do you?
Yes.
Not really. Do you like it?
Yes, love it.
Come on now. It says it delights greatly in his commandments. His, as a result, his seed, verse 2, shall be mighty upon the earth. The generation of the upright shall be blessed. Wealth and riches shall be in his house. His righteousness endures forever. Unto the upright there rises a light in the darkness. He is gracious and full of compassion and righteous. Verse 5, a good man or woman shows favor and lends, and he will guide his affairs with discretion. Surely, surely, he shall not be moved forever. The righteous shall be in everlasting remembrance. He shall not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is fixed. His heart is fixed. Our hearts are fixed here.
Amen.
There's no double. Trusting in the Lord. See, that's what we're fixed on. We're fixed on trusting in the Lord. We believe that God is going to do what he said he would do.
Amen?
Amen?
Yes.
His heart is established. He shall not be afraid until he sees his desires on of his enemies. Verse 9, he has dispersed, he has given to the poor. His righteousness endures forever. His horn shall be exalted with honor. Honor. There's an exalting, a lifting up. Why? Because we lift up the word. The word will lift us up. Amen? In Isaiah chapter 33, verses 5 and 6, King James, it says, the Lord is exalted. He dwells on high. He has filled Zion with judgment and righteousness, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability. That word stability, that's the same word as faithful. So, it's the same word as faithful. So, if you're going to be stable, steadfast, why? Wisdom and knowledge of the word will make you that way. Of thy times and strength of your salvation, the fear of the Lord is his treasure. So the word is going to keep us stable. The word will keep you faithful. Every time. So when you start getting feeling discouraged, grab some of these verses and say, you know something? Hang on a minute. I need to take a break here. I need to say some things over myself. And carry yourself over to the mirror and say, hey, listen, we're going to have a discussion right here, right now. We're going to do some talking. And you're going to hear me.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen?
Sometimes we got to do that. My goodness. Hey, if you're not talking, somebody's talking to you. Right? And you cannot let that voice have any room in your head at all.
Amen.
It's talking all the time. You say, hey, shut up.
Yeah.
Amen. Proverbs chapter 20, please. Proverbs 20. Hallelujah. Don't be discouraged. Be faithful where you are. Why? Promotion's coming. Promotion's coming. God promotes the faithful. Always. Proverbs 20, verse 6. It says, most men will proclaim everyone his own goodness, but a faithful man who can find? Who can find a faithful man? Actually, it seems to me that faithful people will find you. Look around. We're here because some faithful people decided to talk to us about Jesus. if Pastor Carlo wasn't here with Pastor Gary, I never would have made it here. And he's been faithful all these years, right? So a faithful man, who can find? New Living says, many will say they're loyal friends, but who can find one who's truly reliable? You can be faithful, which is okay. It means you're going to show up, but reliable means you're going to show up on time. Come on now. Yeah. Yep. The Message Bible says, lots of people claim to be loyal and loving, but where on earth can you find one? A lot of people talk the talk, right? And it's like love. Love is a verb. Don't tell me you love me. Show me. So the word discourage means to deprive of courage, to deprive of hope or confidence or dishearten. To discourage is to dishearten by expressing disapproval or by suggesting that a contemplated action or course will probably fail. Well, that ain't going to work. Have you been around them people? Yeah, we're going to move. Oh, we're not moving anywhere. I don't believe that. Hard to believe. Really? Jesus said he'll meet your need. Have you seen my bills? By his stripes you're healed. Let me give you my organ recital. I ache. No. Run away from them, people. Let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 1, please. Deuteronomy chapter 1. And I am going to read this out of the New King James because it made it a little bit more clearer than the these, thous, and thuses. And verse 21 in Deuteronomy chapter 1. It says, look, the Lord your God has set the land before you. Go up and possess it. God said we're moving. Go possess it. As the Lord God of your fathers has spoken to you, do not fear or be discouraged. It's going to take some courage. Where we're going is going to take some courage. And every one of you came near to me and said, let us send men before us and let them search out the land and bring back word to us by the way which we should go up and of the cities to which we shall come. The plan pleased me well, so I took 12 of your men, one from each tribe. Verse 24, and they departed and went to the mountains and came to the valley of Eshcol and spied it out. And they also took some of the fruit of the land in their hands and brought it down to us. And they brought back word to us saying, it is a good land which the Lord our God is giving us. It is good. God gave us a promise. God gave Pastor a word. It is good. We are moving to a city on a hill. Amen. Nevertheless, verse 26. Nevertheless, I hate that word. Nevertheless, you would not go up, but you rebelled against the command of the Lord your God, and you complained in your tents and said, because the Lord hates us. Come on, slap yourself. Anybody that comes up to this says, oh yeah, God hates us. He's just mad at you. He just can't stand you. Please. Because the Lord hates us, he's brought us out of the land of Egypt to deliver us into the hand of the Amorites to destroy us. Where can we go up? Our brethren have discouraged our hearts, saying, get away from people that are of a non-can-do, non-will-do, we-can't-do spirit. Because where we're headed is going to take some faith, it's going to take some courage, and it's going to take some steadfastness, it's going to take some faithfulness. You got to be stable. And know where you're going and know that we're called to be there. And know that God planted us in that spot. And then we go into the land, we take it over. Come on, we want to be in a community. We've never been there before. So how do you act? I don't know. But I'll tell you what, we're going to have some fun. Amen. Well, if you don't know, you can't plan nothing. You can't plan a program because you don't know. You have never been there. Ah! So we just go and flow. That's the ticket. Knock on the door. We've come to bring Acts 29 to you. There is no Acts 29. We are it, right? Yeah. Okay. Because I'm Acts 29. I don't have that in my Bible. It says, our brethren have discouraged our hearts, saying, oh. Don't let people say. Nothing discouraging around. Nothing heard, not a discouraging word. The people are greater and taller than we. The cities are great and fortified up to heaven. That is a big, tall city. Come on now. It's built right up to heaven. Trump Tower is not that tall. Moreover, we have seen the sons of Anakim there. There's giants. There's giants everywhere. Pfft, whatever. In Numbers chapter, hang on to there, because we're going to jump back and forth here. In Numbers chapter 13, it's the same story, but I just like verse 30. I love this. Caleb stilled the people before Moses, and he said, let us go up at once. Sometimes you have to still people that are naysayers, discouragers. And sometimes that still is like, you got to shut up. Show them some of your greatest hits. And then pray for them later. Walk into this. He said he stilled the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and possess it. That's what pastor said. Pastor said, we're going to have 3,000 people. Well, I don't believe that. There's not 3,000 chairs here. Is that going to stop God? We got social media. We got all kinds of stuff. God's got a million ways. He's got 3,000 different ways to get 3,000 people here. And the cool thing is that we're part of it. Amen. And it says, let's see where we can take it. Verse 33, and we saw the giants, the son of Anak, which come of the giants, and we were in our own sight as grasshoppers, and so were we in their sight. You don't know how people are thinking. You don't know what people think about you unless you listen to what they're saying. And if you listen to what people say about you, you will not do nothing. You will not do nothing. You get that spirit of Eeyore on you. Oh, well. Nothing really works for me. Blah, blah, favor. No, flavor. I don't have favor. Please. All right. Numbers chapter 14, verses 1 to 9. It says, all the congregation lifted up their voice and cried, and the people wept that night. From a report. They wept all night long. That's crazy. From the news, yeah. From a nevertheless, made them cry. And all the children of Israel murmured against Moses, against Aaron. The whole congregation said unto them, would God that we had died in the land of Egypt. Come on. Really? You think they meant that? Who wants to die? Anybody? Today? No. We got too much to do. It said... Would God that we had died in the land of Egypt, or would God we have died in this wilderness? And wherefore has the Lord brought us up into this land to fall by the sword, that our wives and our children should be a prey? Were it not better for us to return to Egypt? Did they forget where they came from? Don't you forget where you came from. Don't forget what God brought you from. Come on, we're over our neck in it. And God delivered us. So don't think it's going to be better back in the world. Well, it's better back in the bar. Really? Have you seen those floors? I played at this one place that it started as a wood floor and grew into a rug. That's nasty. Oh, no, 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 no. Would to God. Yeah? No. And they said to one to another, let us make a captain and let us return to Egypt. You start hearing people talk that way, chase them off. Then Moses and Aaron fell on their faces before all the assembly of the congregation of the children of Israel, and Joshua the son of Nun and Caleb the son of Jethro, and were of them that searched the land. They tore their clothes. You ever notice how much they tear their clothes in the Old Testament? Man, they just get mad and they just start ripping. Wow. Anyways, and they spoke to all the company of the children of Israel, saying, if they're talking to all the people, they had to do some screaming. They had to be loud. Because in order to overcome the murmuring of, what is that, over 3 million people, two guys. And they spoke to all the company of the children of Israel, and they said, the land which we passed through to search it, it's exceeding good land. And if the Lord delights in us, and he does, then he will bring us into this land and give it to us, the land which flows with milk and honey. Only rebel ye not against the Lord, neither fear the people of the land. We need to make sure that we don't fear the people of the land that we're going into. Because we're going into a community. We're going into a promised land that God has promised us. And there may be giants, but we're big. God is bigger than a giant. Praise the Lord. But we're going to go in and possess it. We're not just going to go in and just hide in a little corner. No, we're going to show it, put our light up on a hill and light that thing up. Come on now. And put our flag in and say, hey, we're not going to be silent. We're here. It says, rebel ye not against the Lord, neither fear ye the people of the land, for they are bread for us. They're bread for us. Their defense is departed from them, and the Lord is with us. Fear them not. Sounds like the spirit of faith, doesn't it? Now, back to Deuteronomy. Chapter 1, verse 29. It says, then I said to you, do not be terrified or afraid of them. The Lord your God who goes before you, he will fight for you. We're not fighting this thing. He's going before us to clear the path. All we got to do is move in and take over. He will fight for you according to all he did for you in Egypt before your eyes. Do you remember how he brought you out the first time? Do you remember how he brought you out the second time? Do you remember how he brought you out the third time? Well, he's going to do it again. He's going to do it again. And he said, according to all he did for you in Egypt before your eyes and in the wilderness where you saw how the Lord your God carried you as a man carries his son in all the way. It says in the New King James, in all the way. He's not going to just leave us on the outskirts of town. He's going to carry us in all the way. He's going to take us in deep in the middle of that community. We take our flag. Bam! We're here. How you like me now? He said he's going to carry you as a man carries his son in all the way that you went until you came into this place. We're going in all the way, you guys. We're not going to stay on the outskirts of town. No more. Yet for all of that, you did not believe the Lord your God, even after all of that, who went in the way before you to search out a place for you to pitch your tents, to show you the way that you should go in the fire by night and the cloud by day. We got a better witness now. We have the Holy Ghost, right? Amen. We got the wind and fire all inside us. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Deuteronomy chapter 28, please. Or 20. Chapter 20, verse 8. Because there may be some. There may be some. And the officer shall speak further unto the people, and they shall say, what man is there that is fearful or faint-hearted? There may be some. Let him go and return to his house, lest his brethren's heart faint as well as his heart. See, discouragement is contagious. And you can't let that stuff around you. No. We're faith people. We can't be around doubt and unbelief. New Living says the officers will say, is anyone here afraid or worried? You can't have fear. You cannot let worry in. If you are, you may go home. Go home. Go home. Because we got business to do. And it's serious business. Message, the officers will then continue. Is there a man here who is wavering in resolve? Are you wavering resolve? Are you afraid? Let him go home right now so that he doesn't infect his fellows with his timidity and cowardly spirit. Kind of tells it right there, doesn't it? Yeah. Don't allow yourself to get infected. We're going in. And it's going to be so, so good. Lamentations. There's a place. We don't go there very often, but I found something really cool there. Lamentations chapter 3. And if you can't find it, just listen. I remember doing that, trying to, I'm just going to open my Bible and just kind of find it. No. Anyways, it says in verses 21 to 24, it says, "This I recall to my mind, therefore I have hope. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness." He's faithful, but his faithfulness is great. Great. That's biggie size faithful. Because, you know, we were talking about us being faithful, but think about the faithfulness of God. His faithfulness is great. It says, "The Lord is my portion, says my soul, therefore I'll hope in him." New Living, it says, "Yet I still dare to hope when I remember this. The faithful love of the Lord never ends." It never ends. "His mercies never cease. Great is his faithfulness. His mercies begin afresh each morning. And I say to myself," self, "the Lord is my inheritance, therefore I will hope in him." We need to be saying that. Self, self. "The Lord is my inheritance, therefore I will hope in him." Message. There's one other thing I remember, and remembering, I keep a grip on hope. Hang on to it. God's loyal love couldn't have run out. His merciful love couldn't have dried up. They're created new every morning. How great is your faithfulness? Sometimes you might need to sit back and say, "God, how great is your faithfulness?" Well, let's see. Let's do like David in the "I remember the lion. I remember the bear." And so we're going to have to deal with some uncircumcised Philistines. Whatever. Doesn't matter. It says, "They're created new every morning. How great is your faithfulness?" I'm sticking with God, and I say it over and over. He's all I've got left. When you get to the point where God is all you got, that is all you need. Then we win. Because then there's no room for backing out. There is no room for a side escape. It's like, "God, it's you or it's nothing." And we know. We know. He never fails. Let's go to Luke chapter 12, please. Luke 12, verse 42. "And the Lord said, who then is that faithful and wise steward whom his Lord shall make ruler over his household, to give them their portion of meat in due season? Blessed is that servant whom his Lord, when he comes, shall find him so doing. Of a truth, I say to you, that he will make him ruler over all that he has." When you become faithful in what you're in the little things, God will reward you with some big time stuff. Always. And you can't outgive God. And we're not being faithful to get stuff. We're faithful because that's what we do. It's like human beings breathe air. Well, you're a Christian. So you should just be faithful. It should be part of your characteristic of what you do. It shouldn't be something that, "Well, I have to work out being faithful again. Praise the Lord." No, it's what we do. Luke chapter 16, please. Verse 10, "He that is faithful in that which is least Leaders, are you faithful to show up? Are you faithful to call your people? That's the least, right? People that come here on here, look around. This is a faithful Thursday night people. Look around. It's always, it's the same people. You know the faces. You know Thursday night people. It says, he which is faithful in that which is least is also faithful in much. And he that is unjust in the least is also unjust in much. If therefore you have not been faithful in the unrighteous mammon, who will commit to you your trust? Who will commit to you to your trust the true riches? If you have not been faithful in that which is another man's, who shall give you that which is your own? So many people want to sit back and say, well, you know, I can't wait till I have my own ministry. And, you know, I'm going to go out and start my own church. I'm going to do this, blah, 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 blah. Well, have you been faithful where you've been serving? Seed time and harvest time. If you're not going to be faithful to the man of God that you serve, and then you go out on your own, and you're expecting blue ribbon sheep to serve you, but you're not serving? I got some news for you. Not so much. Praise the Lord. So, faithful, New Testament, pistos, trusty. Use the persons who show themselves faithful in the transaction of business, in the execution of commands, or the discharge of official duties. In other words, you come in, you do your job. But you do it better than everybody else. Why? Because you like it. There's a servant on the inside of you wanting to serve, right? Means faithful, dependable, and credible. We used to say fat. Faithful, available, and teachable. Same thing, right? We want a bunch of fat people in this place. And not chunky monkeys. I'm talking about faithful, available, and teachable people. And that's what we are. If not, we wouldn't have, come on, we paid this building off in, what, 5 years? There are people in this park that are still paying off their mortgage every month and still nowhere near to what we are. Come on. Yeah. Amen. God, like Pastor said on Sunday, God didn't drop the money out of heaven. It came out of fat people. Faithful, available, and teachable. That know how to sow. And we did. And so, and God blessed us, and we sowed. And God blessed us, and we sowed. And God blessed us, and we sowed. And now we move. Isn't it great? Come on. This is awesome. But it took discipline. Proverbs 10, verse 17. It says in the message, the road to life is a disciplined life. Ignore correction and you're lost for good. Well, you ain't going to tell me what to do. Pastor ain't telling me nothing. Ignore correction and you're lost for good. The road to life is a disciplined life. Ignore correction and you're lost for good. The Message Bible in Proverbs 11:11, it says, when right living people bless a city, it flourishes. What are you saying about your city? We can say it's bread for us. It's bread for us. When right living people bless a city, it flourishes. Evil talk turns it into a ghost town in no time. Why? Our words have power. Verse 14 in Proverbs 11. Without good direction, people lose their way. That's why we come here. We want to make sure that we're on the right path and that we are on the right way, right? And we get good direction here. We get great teaching here. Amen? So we're not losing our way, and we lose none. The more wise counsel you follow, the better your chances. Isn't that good? The more wise counsel you follow, the better your chances. Proverbs 11:24 in the Message, it says, the world of the generous gets larger and larger. The world of the stingy gets smaller and smaller. The one who blesses others is abundantly blessed. Those who help others are helped. We've helped a lot of churches in this place, out of little Dartmouth, Nova Scotia. We've impacted people all over the world. Come on, Pastor bought paid a church off with his credit card in Ukraine. I preached in that church. Pastor Victor, woo-hoo-hoo, what a time. Dartmouth, Nova Scotia, impacting the world. We taught in the Philippines 7 times. Out of Dartmouth, Nova Scotia. Who knew? God did. God did. Romans chapter 1, please. No. Oh, no. We have more places to go. There's places on that map that we haven't hit yet. The land of the barking deer. Remember that? Robert Slairden, he was talking about there's a place that has barking deer. You'll have to go find it. All right. Romans 1, 16. It says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. So when we move into our new place and we start going into a new community, we're not going to be ashamed of the gospel. It's good news. We've got good news to bring these people. And when you know that and you go in with your attitude, hey, listen, I got some good news for you. You go to a good restaurant, you tell people that you went to a good restaurant, don't you? There's good food there. Well, we're going to tell people, hey, there's good food in this place. We serve it up real good. We serve it up right. Right? It said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it, this good news, is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith, which makes us courageous, because courageous people don't get discouraged, because we know what to do when it tries to get on us. Right? We just get around some other faithful people and just say, hey, listen, preach. Sometimes you just have to. There's people that I know. There's people that I, you know, there's people that I call. There's messages that I listen to in case of emergencies, you know, break glass and listen. Right? And you need to have that. So in Proverbs 28, we said it earlier, a faithful man shall abound with blessings. Now, the word abound, I found this in dictionary.com. It says to exist in great quantities or numbers. We're going to abound in great quantities, great numbers, to be rich or well supplied, usually followed by in, to be filled, to be abundant, to come together in great numbers, to overflow and to run over. So we are going to overflow. We're going to run over with blessings. Get ready. It's coming. In the Old Testament, abound, in the Hebrew, it says, many great, large, prestigious, powerful, abundant in quantity, abundant in size, abundant in number, exceedingly, full increase, manifold things, too much. Too much. I like that one. We got too much God. Whew. Plenteous. Hallelujah. So faithful means sticking with God and His Word no matter what happens in your life. That's what we do. We all go through stuff, but we're faithful to stick with God through it all. Being steadfast in your allegiance to God, unwavering loyalty to God, a firm resistance to the temptation to give up, to draw back, or to compromise. We don't quit. We're not quitters. God promises that if you stick with His Word, you will abound in blessings. He promises that if you'll be steadfast in your allegiance to Him, you'll abound in blessings. He said, He promises that if you have unwavering loyalty to Him, you will abound in blessings. Hebrews 10:39, it says, we are not of them that draw back. We don't do that. Message says, we're not quitters who lose out. Oh, no, we stay with it, trusting God all the way. So be encouraged. Don't get discouraged if you don't see things happening in your life immediately. Have faith and know that God is working behind the scenes. Amen. He's working and he's doing it on your behalf, on purpose. So John 14 says, let not your heart be troubled. Can you handle a couple more verses? Okay. 2 Corinthians chapter 1. Let not your heart be troubled. Don't let trouble get in. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 9. Stir yourself up. Don't be discouraged. Be faithful and know that God is working it all out. He's got this, and he's got you. He's got us. We got each other. It says, but we, verse 9, we have the sentence of death in ourselves, that we should not trust in ourselves, but in God, which raises the dead, who delivered us from so great a death, and does deliver it, in whom we trust that he will yet deliver us. Past, present, and future. New Living, it says that he did rescue us from mortal danger. He will rescue us again. We have placed our confidence in him, and he will continue to rescue us. Come on, it is perpetual. There is a perpetual rescuing that's going to go on. Come on, even Charles, I remember Charles Capp said, the grace of God will even make your mistakes to prosper. Come on now. Oh yeah, so you can't be walking around all fear. What if I make a mistake? Well, what if you do? What if you do? Come on, do like God told Job. Pull up your pants and like a man. Right? Just man up. It's not a big deal. Okay, here's the last one. This is a good one. This is where I wanted to get to from the very beginning. Turn to Deuteronomy chapter 2. Deuteronomy chapter 2. And it's funny because I started working on this earlier in the week, and our Bible readings are taking us there. For those of you that are doing the Bible reading, which you really should be doing, and you know, when like pastor suggested that we should read the Bible together. Really wasn't a suggestion. Just saying. He mentioned the Ephesians prayers. They work. I do it every morning. Praise the Lord. Deuteronomy chapter 2. Verse 1. It says, then we turned and took our journey into the wilderness by way of the Red Sea, as the Lord spoke to me. And we compassed Mount Seir many days. And the Lord spoke unto me, saying, you have compassed this mountain long enough. We have been in this place long enough. It is time to pack up and move. Woohoo! If he said it, we agree with it. Come on now. We have placed our confidence in him, and he will continue to move us. We're not staying in, hey, we go to the next place. Like Pastor said, we're not staying there. New Living Bible, it says, you have stayed here long enough. You have stayed here long enough. Get ready. Abundance is here. We have stayed in poverty long enough. Healing is here. We have stayed in sickness long enough. Deliverance is here. We have, come on now, we've been dealing with this stuff long enough now. Right. Now's the time. Right. Amen? Your miracle is here. We've been talking about miracle days are here again. Now! It's not tomorrow. It's now. We have seed in the ground. Our seed is working all the time. We got tons of seed in the ground. We got thousands. We must be into the million flow for our harvest by now. At least million flow. Amen. So we're not going to grow weary and well-doing or doing well. That's just what we do. We're faithful people. This is what we do. This is how we are. This is how we act. Faithful. and fat. Faithful, available, and teachable. Fat. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's what I've got for today. Hallelujah. We are going. We have stayed here long enough. I remember Pastor said that a couple months ago. He said, man, I've been here too long. And this is the longest, really, this has been the longest we've ever been in one place. And don't like it. That's weird. Yeah. Yeah.
It's been great.
It has. Oh, it's been, oh my, if these walls could talk, the anointings that have been in this place, oh, the people that go in here after, because you know there's residue, right? It's like those catacombs with the hanging things. Blessing, blessing, blessing. Why do I feel I need to get saved? Because they're going to have blessing, drip. So praise the Lord.